So we are headed up the road about a mile, and we're going to go look at the drip irrigation in carrots. Introduction to hybrid carrots and onions and parsley really drove the need for pollination. And we don't have native bees in high population in Central Oregon. We would not have carrot, onion, or parsley hybrid seed without the use of bees. And as the hybrid market became more prosperous and people were the need became more to grow hybrid carrots, more acreages were planted. And then, of course, we had to bring in bees.
The two characteristics of these two parents together make up the hybrid. And so this one may have a super-duper flavor, and this one may have great color. That's how you make a hybrid. You take the male, get the bees to do a happy dance on it, and they make a seed.
You're bringing in a component like you would a child. You know, you have blue eyes, your husband has, you know, brown hair, and you get a child that has blue eyes and brown hair.
This field's being irrigated right now. I don't know exactly where, but you don't see any water anywhere. That's the nice thing about drip. It's efficient, bee-friendly, which is important to us, because if we don't have bees, we don't have a crop. If you look at the data from year to year, it's pretty obvious that crops under drip irrigation do better.
Portion of that because you're getting better pollination. When crops are under sprinkle irrigation, the bees can't work that section while it's being sprinkled. So if you aren't putting water out there, bees can work all day long, as opposed to, you know, it may be flowering, it may be perfect flowering time, and bees can't get out and work it because they don't want to get wet. We introduced a pheromone that stimulates the hive into thinking it has more babies or brood to take care of. And by doing that, then they concentrate on not traveling as far and maybe working a little harder. We did that for 4 years, and the data showed that we had better yields on those fields that the brood pheromones were used as opposed to those that were not. Some of these crops are not really appetizing to them. If we can keep them on this field and they work this field really hard, the better pollination and the better yield we'll get. And this year we're working on nutrition. We want these bees to leave Central Oregon as healthy as they can be when they are done doing their job. Can we plant a really good pollen source right next to the field so that towards the end of the season when, you know, the carrot seed is finishing up its pollination and the bees are looking for more protein, can they go to this strip of flower seed that we have planted next to the field and get that source of pollen they need before they go into winter? And they also need to have a lot of honey before they go into winter. That's what gets them through the winter months. Because if they're stressed or they're not healthy going into winter, if bees aren't in good nutrition, they're more susceptible to disease. We are trying to help the beekeepers make sure that when their bees leave our area, that they're as nutritionally healthy as we can possibly provide for them.